Hi, my name is Aaron. Congratulations on the purchase of your new Arctic Spa with the Spa Boy Water Care System. To the right of me, I have some of the main components that you're gonna need to care for your water. So let's get started. So to the table right to the right of me, we have probably the most common products you're gonna find in your startup kit. And first off, we have our Onzen Dead Sea Salt. So this is a 2 kilogram pail. Depending on the size of your spa, you may have more, you might need more, but for the sake of this demonstration, we're just gonna use a 2 kilogram pail. Next we have Boost, which is a granular chlorine. This is a different style, type of chlorine than what's gonna be produced from your salt system, but it's good to have on hand in case we need it. And we have Salt Water Balance. This is the main balancing product that we need to use for your Spa Boy unit. This is essentially going to adjust your pH level down. We also have Refresh, which is a commonly referred to as a shock or an oxidizing agent. Now you may have peak ozone installed in your spa, so this isn't something that's going to need to be used regularly, but it's good to have on hand. We also have some testing equipment like our salt test strips, so we can make sure that our salt level is exactly where it needs to be. And we have our OTO test kit so we can effectively test the water. Now, Spa Boy will test the water for you and relay that information to your Arctic Spa app, but it is good and recommended from time to time to test the water to just make sure that what's actually happening in the water is being displayed to you on your app. So the first thing we wanna do is make sure we get the salts into the water as quickly as we possibly can. So while your spa is filling up and getting heated or getting heated up, we wanna make sure that the water temperature is about 90 degrees Fahrenheit before we place the water in. Or what you can do is you can go to your tap water and you can fill up a clean bucket full of water. We can pour in the recommended amount of salt into that bucket and dissolve it first and then pour it directly into your spa. Now the amount of salt that you're going to add is going to be specific to the Arctic Spa that you purchased. So what you want to do is refer to your user manual. Inside your user manual, you're going to have a Spa Boy section which will show you a Spa Boy dosage chart or salt water dosage chart. Or you can go refer to the app. Once you don't have to actually log into the app, you can just download the app to your smart device, and then when you log into the main page, you can go to this little binder icon at the top. It's gonna bring you to our user manual section, which you can then can click on the Spa Boy / Onzen section. And then from there, you can select the salt dosage chart. And what you wanna do is you wanna scroll and find your spa. If you had purchased, for instance, let's say a Summit model, then the recommended dosage would be 3 kilograms. So referring to the pail of Dead Sea Salt, Onzen Dead Sea Salt, you can see that this is a 2 kilogram pail. So in this case and scenario, since this is a Summit model, we would need 2 buckets. And what I would do is I would dissolve the first bucket completely and then half of the second bucket for the full 3 kilograms. Now after we've added the salt, one of the things that salt will do is it has a tendency to want to drive your pH up. So to the right of me, I have Salt Water Balance. This is a product that we're going to use to adjust your pH down, okay? And I also have the app open on our testing page so we can see the results of what's happening in the water. Now in this case and scenario, we'll see in the bottom bar that our pH is high. That's generally what's gonna happen once you add the salt. And actually it will continue to happen for the first week, week and a half. So for the first little while after you add the salt to the water and as that salt dissolves into the water, we're gonna have to be pretty continuously checking out in the app and adjusting our pH down. Now the nice thing is once we get past that week or week and a half, the spa is gonna hit what we call equilibrium. That's when your pH is gonna stabilize and stay in the green area, right where we wanna be, and everything will be good. But until then, we need to adjust our pH down. Now in this case, in the scenario, our pH is showing red high. So we're 2 levels off of the okay or ideal range. So in this case and scenario, on the first startup, the first time, let's add in 2 caps of the Salt Water Balance. Now you may wanna refer to your preferred dealer and see how much they recommend based on your location, but generally 2 caps right after you add the salt is a good way to do it. Now, to add the salt or the pH down to, or the Salt Water Balance to your spa, you simply want to undo the lid, pour in the Salt Water Balance till you have 1 full cap. Then we're going to turn our jets on. Whenever we're mixing this product into the water or any product into the water, you always want to make sure your jets are on so it can dissolve into the water effectively. So turning on the pumps, we're just gonna pour one cap in, and then we're gonna do a second cap. Make sure that's nice and level, and a second cap. And let that run for a full cycle. Your jets will run for 20 minutes cycles, so at the end of the 20 minutes, you're good to go. Now, as the salt's dissolving into the water and we're adjusting our pH, your water will go cloudy for the first little while this all takes into the water. It won't be long though before it comes clear. This can take up to the first 24 hours, depending on your location and your water quality. Now, this is a great time to test our salt level to make sure it's at the proper recommended range. The nice thing with this is once we get it into the proper recommended range, we don't really have to do this test a whole lot until we either do a top up or a drain and fill, or if we have reason to believe that we need to test it again. So to the right of me, I have some salt water test strips that would be provided to you in your startup kit, and I have a clear glass. Now, for you at home, the best way to take a sample of the water to do this test with would be to use a shot glass, because we don't want to get the top of the test strip wet. So in this demonstration, I'm going to use just a regular glass. I'm only going to take out a little bit of the water, probably about an ounce, and that should be good. And then I'm going to take our test strip, and I'm going to add it to the water. Now, the important thing here is we want to make sure we're not getting the top of the salt test strip tab wet, the part that says Quantap. Okay, we want to place it into the water in our cup, and we want to make sure that it stays there so it's not going to get the top of that tab wet. Now, I'm going to do a quick zoom in for you, and we're going to show you that the top of the tab has an orange horizontal strip. Now, that orange horizontal strip needs to turn completely black before this test is done. This can take anywhere from 2 to 5 minutes. Once the test strip does turn black, it will show you your reading on the test strip, and we want to make sure that our range for our salt content is between 2200 parts per million to 2500 parts per million. Now, if you're a little bit over or under, that's okay. We don't have to panic, but that is the recommended range you want to be in. If we are quite a bit lower, then you can add a little bit more salt or top up appropriately. And if you happen to be a little bit higher, then again, we don't really have to worry too much about it, but if we're really high into like the 3000 parts per million range, then we're probably going to want to drain a little bit of water out and re-top it up. Okay, so it's been about 3.5 minutes and my salt test is done. I know this again because the top of the Quantab is now black. And I have a reading here. I can see that my reading has actually changed from a red to an orangey color. And it brings up the reading to about 5 on this test. Now, when I refer to the bottle, I'm gonna see that the ranges are in parts per million. I said 2200 to 2500 parts per million. That correlates with a number. In this case and scenario, that range would be 5.7 to 6.0. Now, when you look at this, I'm a little bit short, so I'm just gonna top up with a little bit more salt and we're gonna get this perfect. So now that your salt's dissolving into the water and we're balancing our pH, your Spaboy app is going to have an automatic testing page, which is phenomenal. So this right here is a OTO test kit. Inside the kit, you're going to have a set of instructions that you can refer to later. You're also going to have your testing equipment. So we have OTO drops for pH and for chlorine. It's reversed. So the idea is what you want to do is you want to reach into your spa about arm length and you want to go elbow deep to get enough water for your test. I'm not going to go that deep because I don't want to get wet. On the OTO test kit, you're going to have 2 lines at the top for each vial. That's where we need the water to level to be. So you just want to flip it up, flick out the water until you're at those marks. And then you're going to take your chlorine test. That's the yellow bottle marked one. And what we want to do is we want to put in 5 drops into the vial. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we don't want to hold it directly up and down. We want to hold it a little bit more to the angle so we can control how the drop goes in. And then we're going to do the same for the pH side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we have 2 little caps that can go on top of the vial. Now you might feel like you want to put your fingers or thumbs over top and shake it up without putting the caps on, but the oils from your skin can contaminate the results, and we don't want that. So we just want to shake that up. And then what we're going to do is we're going to look at our test. So now we have our test results. Now what you're going to notice is that on the yellow side, we have a bunch of different yellow colors, and we want to match up the color of the vial to this yellow range. Now your proper parts per million for chlorine is between one part per million and three parts per million. You actually have an ideal range indicator on the test tube. I just want to match it up. But a good rule of thumb to go by is that if the vial is clear, you don't have any chlorine. If it's any shade of yellow, you do have chlorine. We just want to make sure it's the proper shade. And if it's any other color other than yellow, like blue, purple, red, that would all indicate that your chlorine is way too high. On the pH side, we want to match again the color vial up with the color code. Now this is a little bit easier just because the colors are very different. So bright pink, peachy color, yellow, and we can really match it up easily. Now the ideal range for your pH, what we want to keep for Spa Boy, is 7.2. Now 7.2 is going to maintain proper chlorine levels. It's also normally the pH level of everybody's skin. Now everybody's a little bit different, so some people's pH might be a little bit different, but 7.2 is going to feel the closest to you, so it's going to make the water feel the nicest. Okay, so now we're pretty much done. That's the benefit of Spa Boy. It really makes water care maintenance fairly easy. Right here we have our test results showing the chlorine being perfect in the green and our pH being perfect in the green as well. Now your main week-to-week maintenance, or as it happens, because it's not really a week-to-week maintenance, but as you watch the app, your levels are going to change a little bit. Your chlorine could go up, it could go down, but so will your pH. Now generally speaking, as your pH climbs up, your chlorine level will show as going down. As your pH goes down, your chlorine level can show going up. So in order to control those levels and make sure that they're always in the green, just like in this demonstration, we have salt water balance and adjust up from R to Pure. Now you might want to refer to your preferred dealer to see what they recommend to use for products for balancing pH, but mostly what you're going to be using is salt water balance, because again, salt wants to drive pH up, and that will continuously happen. We're going to want to generally just keep bringing it down. So as it goes up to a color code, you're just going to want to add in a cap of salt water balance. If it goes up two color codes, so it goes from green to high, then generally that's two circles and representing two caps. If you ever go low on pH, now the first thing is not to really panic and not to really do a whole lot. What you want to do is you want to see it go into the yellow low or the red low and give it a couple, you know, about 24 hours and see if it comes up naturally. If it doesn't, then at that point in case in time, then we can add in Arctic Pure Adjust Up. This should bring up the pH. If it doesn't bring up the pH, or if it does but it seems like it keeps going down low, then you might want to do a manual test for alkalinity, which you can refer to from your preferred dealer and see if we need to adjust that level. We didn't really cover alkalinity. It's not something that's really going to affect the spa or affect your water care, but it does affect pH over a period of time. Now, although we're done for our general maintenance on the spa, there can be some issues that arise from time to time just through overusage or things being spilt in water, so on and so forth. Now, one of those things is your chlorine level. So what your system is producing is a chloride chlorine. Now, this product next to me is called Boost, and you might get this in your startup kit. This is a granular instant amount of chlorine. It's a dichlorochlorine, so it's very common to what you would see as a pool chlorine. Now, this is not something that you have to add regularly, but you might want to add it from time to time if you see your chlorine level drop low and we want to bring it up. Now, before we do add this product, I just want to highlight that we do have a boost button on this page. So that's going to run your cell for your chlorine production. That will bring your chlorine up quicker than normal. So you can try that first, but if it's not coming up quick enough for you, then you can add some boost. Now, when you go to add this product, it is an instant amount of chlorine, and it's a smelly chlorine, so you're going to smell it right away. That's the nice thing with Spa Boy, is you normally don't smell that. So when adding this, you want to make sure that you're adding very little at a time and judging from the app as the chlorine level comes up. So the amount that I would add just to try and get that level up a little bit is just to coat the bottom of the cap or use potentially a quarter cap if we want to jump a couple levels. So you simply just pour that into the vial, start your jets, because you always want to make sure you're mixing product in with your jets running, and throw it into the spa. Now that everything is balanced, you're going to be using your spa, and probably a lot. So as you're using it and your friends and family are coming over, we're introducing a lot of contaminants into the water. The chlorine's job is to hunt down those contaminants and render them ineffective. This process is going to transform your free chlorine into what we call combined chlorine. Now, a buildup of this combined chlorine can lead to some not nice things in water. Some of the symptoms of a large amount of combined chlorine in your water is cloudy water, foamy water, or a smell. Now, if any of those things are happening in your water, the thing we can do is what we call in the industry as shocking the water or oxidizing the water. This product next to me is called Refresh. This is the product we want to use if we want to help that along quickly to bring it back to a clean, clear state. Now, this product is an oxidizer. It's going to lift all that combined chlorine up and out of the water. So in order to do this properly, we want to make sure that your cover is all the way off. Now, most of the products you could mix into the water with your cover half on and half off, but not this product. If your cover is half on and half off, then all the combined chlorine is going to be oxidizing up and out, and it's going to hit the bottom of the cover and bounce right back in the water, and it's not going to do anything for you. So let's remember to leave the cover all the way off. We're going to open up the bottle, we're going to put in a full cap, and we're going to turn on your jets, and we're going to add it to the water. Now, as your spa usage does increase, we have lots of products on our bodies like makeup, hair products, deodorants, perfumes, and just detergents from our swimwear that will come off in the water. Now, when this does happen, you can get a buildup of oil-based substances in the water, which are actually going to be lighter than water, so they'll float to the surface, and this can give you ring around the tub. We don't want that. So this product next to me is called Azorbi. Now, there's a very few different types of products in the industry that are like this, so just refer to your preferred dealer and see what they recommend. What this product will do is it's going to float around the surface level of the water, and it's going to pick up all those oil-based products. So we're not going to get any type of discoloring or ring around the tub. Now, I'm going to show you how to work this. Now, I've opened up this product, and right away we're going to see we have these tassels. Now, this is a good way to tie this off in the spa on a headrest or maybe on your filter canisters. If you're okay with it floating around in the spa, then you can actually remove these tassels. Just simply grab one and give it a nice tug, and you can pull them both off. Now, once we have our Azorbi, we just want it to float around in the spa. It will start picking up the oil-based substances, which is fantastic. As it does so, though, it's going to get heavier, and it's going to start to sink into the water. Now, it might go a little bit at an angle or get submerged a little bit. At that point, it's still a good product. You can still let it go, and it will still work for you. But when it gets fully submerged underwater, that's when the product is done and it needs to be replaced. Now, good tip. As company or friends or family come over, it's advisable to remove the Azorbi from the water before they get into the spa. Because the first thing they're gonna do when they get in there is they're gonna pick it up and they're gonna squish it, and then they're gonna ask you what it's for. By that time, it's too late. Now, at this point, you are totally done with your regular care and maintenance of your spa boy system. However, from time to time, there are some additional products that we can add and use to help our overall hot tubbing experience. The first one, and the best product, and one I highly recommend, is Just Blue. Now, Just Blue is a product that's going to essentially clean out all the plumbing in your spa. So, calcium buildup can affect the plumbing lines, and what this product will do is, when you add it, it's going to flush out your lines, which is really, really good. The actual dosage for this product is actually on the back on this diagram, and it's going to actually indicate how much to add for whichever Arctic spa you own. So just look up your spa model, refer to the chart, and add a cap of that amount once a week. Now, the next product we have is Fresh Start. Now, Fresh Start is a full hot tub flush. This is a great product to use when you're draining your Arctic spa. This product is going to clean out all the lines and get rid of any type of excess buildup. Now, how do you use this product is you want to make sure that you take your filters completely out of the spa, and you want to make sure that your water temperature is at least at 90 degrees Fahrenheit. If you notice on the bottle, you have measurements. You want to add 8 ounces into the water, and you want to run your jets. Your jets run in intervals of 20 minutes at a time. we want to run this product for about 2 hours. So you're going to probably have to go out a couple more times and start up the jets again. Your spotted waters can get very fizzy and very foamy, but that's okay. That's what we want to happen. At the end of the 2 hours, turn it off and drain out the spa. Now the last product we have is Cover and Cabinet Renew. Your spa is outside in the elements 365 days a year with the sun beating down on it. So UV rays can really impact the cabinet and the cover. This product provides a nice layer of protection for the vinyl of your cover or your cabinet. So whenever you do a drain and fill, the nice thing to do is spray this product directly onto like a cloth or a microfiber cloth and rub it directly onto the cabinet and rub it onto your vinyl cover to give you a nice layer of protection. Now, part of your Spa Boy maintenance care program is to care for your salt cell. That's this device here. Now, this cell is protected against your manufacturer warranty. However, it is a consumable, so it will go defective from time to time. You'll know because you have a battery symbol here on your app, which generally shows the lifespan of the cell. It will start off at green, and then it will go to yellow, and then it will go to red. Typically, when it turns red, it's time to replace the cell. However, the first thing you want to check before you replace your cell is to make sure that your salt level is at the proper recommended range. So simply do a salt test first if your battery turns red, and if your salt is right where it needs to be between the 2200 to 2500 parts per million range, then it's time to replace your cell. If your salt level isn't and it's low, then it's time to top up your salt and give it 24 hours to see if the battery resets. So in review, caring for the Spa Boy water care system is really quite easy. If your pH is high, we're going to simply add in some salt water balance to bring the level down. And if you've got some cloudy water or some foam buildup, we're going to add refresh. Now the last thing we need to talk about is draining and filling your spa and potentially replacing your salt cell. Let's go. So now let's talk about draining and filling your Spa Boy specific Arctic Spa. It's recommended that you do a drain and fill once a year. We typically want to do this drain and fill as late in the fall as possible. Now the first thing you want to do when it comes time to do a drain and fill is you want to turn the GFCI breaker off or all the power off to your spa. Once the power is off, we want to drain the water, but not all the way down. We want to drain it just to above this fitting. This is where your probe sits that tests the water. To know that, we simply remove this grate by turning counterclockwise. You can feel inside and you'll feel the little glass tube. If that's where it is, you want to take this device, this is a closed sealed fitting, and you want to put this cap directly on to that fitting. Effectively, what you're doing is you're sealing water in there and not allowing the probe to get dried out. Now, once you have the probe capped off and sealed off with water trapped inside, it's time to remove the cell. Now you can drain the rest of the way, or you can do it at this stage with water still in the spa. If you don't want to do a complete drain and fill, but you have to replace your cell, then you don't have to cap the probe off. Instead, you can leave the water level right where it is, and you can still replace the cell. So what you want to do is you want to grab a new cell from your preferred Arctic Spa dealer. You'll also need a screwdriver. It's handy if you're doing this process with the water still full in the spa to use a magnetic tip. Because what you'll notice down low on this, which we'll show you in a moment, is that there's a screw that we have to remove first. Now the first thing we want to do is we want to remove the cell. So we want to grab a hold of it. The first time it might be a little bit sticky, or it might be a little bit difficult to get going, but you just want to give it some good elbow grease, and we want to turn it counterclockwise and fully remove it from the fitting. When you pull it out, you're going to notice that you have this cable. Now you don't want to tug too hard, especially if we have water in the spa, you might want to just pull it up quickly. Just make sure that you're not doing so. You might have an elastic band to try to keep the cord situated inside the fitting properly. So just remove that elastic band, and you can bring this device, this portion of it, above the water level. We don't want to hang it over the side and allow this to have strain, so try to hold it above the water level the entire time. Next, you want to grab your magnetic screwdriver. You want to locate the screw on the one side, and you simply just want to remove that screw. Once you have your screw removed, now you can thread the cell directly away from the niche. Once you take it out, again, remember, we don't want this component to be below the water level. remove the old cell, grab a new one, place it back into the fitting. Now it's important, on the bottom of this, you're gonna see you have this nipple. Again, this cannot get wet. Replace it back into the niche and replace your screw. Once you have the screw back in, now we just gotta feed it back down and make sure we get the cable all the way into the niche fitting. And thread it in. There you have it, you've now replaced your cell. So if you've purchased one of the all-weather pool models from our spa lineup and you're either on a chlorine traditional system or the SpaBoy saltwater system and you're watching these spa schools, then for you, the dosages are a little bit different. If you're on the SpaBoy system and you're looking for your salt level dosage, again, remember to refer to your user manual that you can either have on your manual that came with the spa or on the Arctic Spa app. And when it comes to adding pH reduction or increase or adding a perfect balance or refresh, any of these other products, if I mention one cap, for you it would be double, so that it would be two caps. Come to the end of our video, I hope it's been really informative for you. Lastly, if you have any questions, please contact your preferred dealer. Again, thank you for watching and welcome to the Arctic family.